Hey everyone, welcome back. Okay, so I'm going to do something a little different in this video. I am going to demonstrate how to replace a battery in a 2011 MacBook. It might actually be a late 2010, I can't remember, but the important thing is the model number. All right, so you want to check the model number right here. This is a model number A1286. Okay, so when you order a new battery, check that. I just ordered this battery. It's not made by Mac. It's just a cheap battery I got from Amazon. It was like $35. This laptop has been through so much that it's just not really worth it to put much more into it at this point. I'm amazed it's still running. This thing has been soaking wet. It's been dropped. It's been left outside and just covered in moisture as part of like VJ installation setups. It's seen a lot of miles. Okay, so let's do this. I already unscrewed these screws, right? I actually ordered these screwdrivers, with the battery. So, you're going to need tiny little Phillips head screwdrivers. I already took the screws off, so you don't have to, you know, watch me do that. So let's Okay, so, here we go. There's some screws in here holding the battery down. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and undo those. First time I opened this up, actually, the whole thing was covered in pet hair. I couldn't believe it was still working, but I just used a little turntable brush for the turntable needle and just kind of brushed everything off. You don't, of course, want to really touch any of the components or anything, although, I mean, when I first opened up a laptop like this, I was actually pretty scared I was going to screw something up, but, you know, don't worry. It's actually tougher than you think. So, than you might think. Okay, so, here we go. So, the wires here will actually be taped down. Let me show you on this one here. See, like, it's taped down right here. But it's actually just taped down, so it might seem like it's kind of hard to get in here, but you can actually just kind of yank it up like that and just see the wires will just pull off of there and make room so that you can get in there and unplug this part. So I probably need two hands here and just kind of, there, unplug it. All right. So this little thing is key right here. The different model numbers will have different size plugins right here, okay? So that's the important part. Hopefully the battery I have is gonna fit. We'll see. I mean, I ordered the right model number, but okay, so set that aside. Grab the new one. It looks like it's going to fit. And again, this is taped down right here, but I've just found that kind of pulling that up and just making some room to get in there just helps me fit this in there better. This part's a little bit tricky. So I guess before I do that, I'm going to go ahead and show you. Right here next to the trackpad, there's this little spot right there, a little plug-in right there where I pull the wire out. That's all you gotta do is pop it in, screw it back down, and you should be good to go, all right? So, okay, let's go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and just try and pop this in there. I'm not sure if I need to, yeah, that should work. Okay. Yeah. I'll probably edit the video to make it look like I just did this in like 2 seconds, but I haven't. There we go. All right. Like so. And put that down. Nice. So we're going to put those screws back in. All right. So I did drop one of these screws one time down under the logic board, so be careful. Let's see. Got some of my cat hair in here. All right. I'm telling you, if you own pets and you have an old laptop, man, when you take the top off, I guarantee it's going to be covered with pet hair. Okay. So there's that. Let's see what happens here. This dirty old thing back on. Oh man. There is a couple different size screws here. These things are so tiny though. And last time I replaced the battery, I did drop one of these in my kitchen and could not find it again. But that's fine. And like I said, I'm missing the feet here. That's actually probably pretty bad. You can kind of see inside of there. So maybe I'll just take some gaff tape or something, toss it over that. Okay, there we go. So I guess we shall see what happens. Oh, you gotta love that sound. So this computer would not turn on when it wasn't plugged in before, so we are good. One more thing to note here. Do not throw your old battery in the garbage. Don't do it. Don't do it. Okay? There's that's yeah, these things are not made with the best materials. There are stuff in here that will leak into the ground and do all kinds of damage. So you want to properly recycle your battery. Okay, let's see what's happening here. It's looking good. Everything's gonna be just fine if I plug it in. The light pops on. It's green right now. It should be turning to amber though. There we go. Turn to amber. Yeah, okay, so we're at 69%. So what you wanna do now is you wanna charge it up to 100%. And then you run it down to zero and then charge it back up to 100% again. All right. And yeah, I'm curious to see how long this cheap battery is going to last there. Like I said, this battery was like, oh, 35 bucks or something. It was by a company called Solus. Definitely read the reviews on the batteries. I had another battery picked out. It was a little bit cheaper, and I read through the reviews on Amazon, and people were talking about them swelling up right away. And you don't want that. Okay, there you go. Hopefully that was useful for some of you that are trying to bring one of your old MacBooks back to life. At this point, this thing has died so many times, it's officially a zombie, but it looks like it's still walking. All right, thanks.